What you got to do?
So the goal is to create a virtual reality application where the viewer will be able to see the locations where the tornado went through.
Okay.
Look at the plants that are in there and see how it's different than locations that the tornado didn't go through that are kind of similar.
Okay.
Basically where I'm at with the app is the video, the 360 videos in it, the 360 audios in it. You can move throughout the areas and stuff. All the information is done. I just gotta actually like put it in. And by that I mean like I gotta convert it to a text file and then assign it to locations. Yeah, so speaking of which, that brings me to things to do. So the interview audio needs to be put in. Plant info needs to be converted to text files. I need to fix up the audio player for that so that it works. I need to create the plant buttons for all the scenes. Alright, and then is there anything that we just need to do like for general presentation stuff?
Well, we could take a look at the poster.
Do we need a PowerPoint for Wednesday?
No, it's just a poster presentation.
Okay, sweet.
Alright, well that's good to know.
Hi, I'm Nicolet Schweitzer. I'm a member of the Visualizing Forest Futures team. And I'm currently going to UW South to get my degree in entertainment design, comics, and cultural arts. And I'm just going to pass it down to everyone else in the future system.
Hello, I am Matthew Schweitzer. I'm going to be starting college at Columbia University this fall, and I'm planning on pursuing political science and Middle Eastern, South Asian, and African studies. I got it right this time, yes! And as part of the VIFF team, I worked on the visual and audio, so working with the 360 video and the interviews that we conducted.
Hello, my name is Evelyn Greeno. I am currently a student here at CMN, and I'm 2 semesters away from my business degree, almost there. In this project, I worked more like with the plants and
finding more. Hi, my name is Jacob Schweitzer, the last Schweitzer you'll see out here. I'm currently attending UW Stout to get my degree in computer science with a concentration in game design and development. So for this project, I was the programmer for the app that we made together.
All right, Jacob, what'd you say?
So I'm running into some issues.
Yeah?
So like how you know, the Menominee language, when written it has like special characters, right? Well, Unity doesn't recognize those.
Ooh.
So every time like we put in like special script, like in O with like line over, what I get in Unity is just like a box saying, oh, that doesn't exist. I'll just put something empty.
Oh, the question mark box?
No question mark, but just the box.
What?
Yeah, I know, right?
You don't get this anymore.
Okay, yeah. So what I think I'm gonna have to end up doing is just like use like the normal characters. Because Unity doesn't seem to be recognizing them, so I'm gonna have to and this will suck, but you know, it's what we got, so, yeah.
Dang.
No, don't! You don't get this anymore.
So, now that we've planned what we have to do, now we have to do it. So first, we wanted to talk to a couple of people. We decided to talk to Jeff Brina. He was a former MTE employee, and he's the cultural and that's how I was going to phrase it that I planned in my head but forgot. He is an expert of the cultural sites on the Menominee Reservation. So we wanted to talk to him because he was one of the first people to get to the scar immediately after the tornado. We also talked to John Lampier. John Lampier is a USDA Forest Service officer in the Nicolet National Forest. And he, coincidentally, was also the first responder to the tornado scar in the Nicolet National Forest. And he talked to both of them about what the tornado looked like, what the forest looked like before the tornado, immediately after the tornado, and what the plan was of both their organizations to restore the forest where the tornado went through. We also looked through a lot of species that now live in the tornado scar and also outside of the tornado scar to compare the two. We looked online for information about the 2007 tornado and read some research papers about other wind disturbances to try to figure out what exactly we should be looking for at this wind disturbance. And we then modeled an app to fit the information that we found to share it all with all of you guys.
All right, so for the vlog, what are you guys up to?
Oh, well, today's Wednesday.
Exactly.
We present, 4 hours.
Yeah.
Well, actually, we're last, so it's probably
replacing every plan.
Yeah, we're going through all the footage and stuff. Here, let me just zoom out. So, like, we're going through the locations and then planning out, like, where all the plants are and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really difficult because, you know, it's better to do it when you're there instead of off of a 360 video that you took.
Yeah. I mean, the good thing is, we have this documented for the future. Exactly.
Learn from our mistakes.
Exactly. Yeah. Sounds good.
Which here are only 4 of the 17 that we put into the virtual reality. After we picked out our plants, we took 360 videos of each area. And we did this because then it would help you guys see what we see inside the scar. After that, during the whole process, we had Nick to keep track of our progress during the process. We finished off information on plants as well. There are certain things that we were missing. But we finally got everything in the virtual reality. So, and it was fun seeing all the people be able to see what we were trying to put together and see the input.
So it's time for the program we're going to talk about the app. It was made in Unity, which is a 3D game development engine. Yeah, can I borrow your glasses? I can't see that. I just got my eyes checked. I'm wearing my new glasses. So what the app will do, it will allow the user to move to each site to see the forest succession that's taking place there. The user can view what plants are coming back versus what was there before by looking at both locations. We have 360 video in where this tornado went through on both the Menominee and the Nicolet, and also just outside of the destroyed area. So, you guys, the users, will be able to see the impact of the tornado. So, now in conclusion, what we found was that the Menominee Tribal Enterprise and the USDA Forest Service handled management of the forest after the tornado, kind of similarly, but also differently. MTE allowed only certain tree species to grow back, such as red pine, aspen, and other understory trees. But they allowed it to grow back in a natural way through the seeds that were deposited there after the tornado. Meanwhile, the USDA Forest Service also allowed only certain tree species to grow back, but they brought in seedlings from a company to plant it there.
So the seedlings that they bought were tamarack, red pine, and white pine that they planted right where it got the land.
Because of these different approaches of management towards the forest, we found that the tornado in the Menominee Forest had a harder time touching down because of the density. And also we found that it had positive impacts on the forest as well, such as creating an open area for certain understory plants to grow and certain animals to be able to roam and come in, such as birds who like to communicate within these open areas. What we also found in the Nicolet Forest is that it kind of had a much worse impact just because it was a more open area, and because of their approach, it wasn't as dense for it to have a harder time going through. We'd like to give a special thanks to Chris Caldwell, Erica Smith, who helped us around Penn State, and Amy, who was a big help within this project. We'd like to thank Jeff Greeno, John Lampert,